Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, Sarah from Year of Boxes. I am reviewing Tokyo Treat. This is their April 2017 box, and the last time I reviewed this box was last year. I can't remember what month it was. It was a long time ago. I only reviewed it once. And we've gotten really familiar with this subscription lately because we also review two of their other subscription boxes, Yumi Twins and No Make No Life. So they have a few to choose from and it just is a really fun box. So basically this is a subscription that delivers Japanese snacks and candies to your door. They have a variety, salty, sour, sweet, that kind of thing. They include limited edition treats. They have three different options to choose from. They ship worldwide and shipping is free, which is really cool. And then the options that you have to choose from is the small box, $14.99, the regular box, $24.99, and then the premium box, which is $34.99. I'm reviewing the premium box, and it is packed full. So I'm just gonna do a really just quick overview to show you guys what I have in here. If you've seen my other Japanese treat reviews, I get a little confused sometimes, and I'm just basically gonna show you guys the snacks. I'm not gonna talk about them too much, just quickly, and here is their product little booklet. They have a whole bunch of stuff in here, but what I really like about this is that they outline all of the snacks that you've received. They talk about them, so I like that because I like to know what I'm going to be eating, and then they section them off depending on the box that you've purchased. So these are the snacks in the small box, and then these two rows are the regular box, and then all three rows are the premium box, which very organized. I love that. So one thing that they do in every box is they include this little baggie of treats. So you get a few different ones to choose from. They do this in every box, and it's just a variety of little snacks. I think they're different every time, and I don't know if subscribers get different things, but there's a mixture in there. It looks like some crunchy ones. This is chocolate, I know. This is like a crunchy, like peanut flavored, like chip that's in the shape of like a tube. It's actually kind of good, I've had them before. And anyways, we're gonna go on to the next one. So here we have, these are corn puffs, and they're dashi flavor. No clue what that is. These are, which ones are these? These are rich cheese flavored, they call them scone. And I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but they kind of look like cheesies actually from the look on the bag there. I actually really love cheesies. I'm not supposed to eat them anymore, but. Then we've got these. These are peach gummies, which sound actually really good. And then these are little like chocolate, caramel balls. Wait till it gets in focus. Yeah, they sound really good too. Caramel inside. Then we have this, which this is like one of like the fun, like random ones that they include. So this is a sweets blind box. So you'll find a cherry blossom influenced sweets mini figure, a piece of gum, and a diorama that can be used as a display. That's kind of fun. Oh my goodness. And then we've got this. This looks really good. Baskin Robbins Love Potion. They look like little chocolates with like raspberry in the middle, kind of what those look like. Then we have this. This is just a good old bar of milk chocolate. I love that they include kind of normal things too, and this makes me really happy. No Japanese box would be complete without Pocky, and this is matcha flavored. I love Pocky. Again, not supposed to eat it. I love it. You know what would be really cool is if one of these boxes did a Pocky box and it was themed Pocky and it had all different flavors of Pocky. That would be super fun. Then we've got these. What are these guys? I have to look these ones up. These are candy apple soft candy. Oh, this is like a DIY. So these are like really big in the Japanese treat boxes. I've received these before. You can't really tell. There's a little tray, and then you get like some sort of little candy that you put on a stick, and then you dip it in like chocolate, and then you dip it in like sprinkles, something along those lines. Sounds really fun. These look like Pringles. I love Japanese treats that are kind of a Japanese take on our snacks that we have here. It's totally not getting into focus for you guys. Seriously, there. They are, but they're lobster bisque flavor. So I'm not loving that. I find that with a lot of their like chips and their crunchy snacks, they're like fish flavored, whether it's shrimp or whatever. Not my favorite, but anyways. Then we have these. So this is Pokemon. And these are chocolate wafers. So again, kind of normal. They look kind of good actually from the picture. Then we've got this. Probably holding it upside down. This is again some sort of, this is a honey soy sauce rice cracker. I love rice crackers. Go live on rice crackers. And then lastly, this is the best part. So if you get the premium box, it includes a drink, and this is the drink they included this month. And seriously, this is so fun. So it's just Coca-Cola. It says original taste, so I don't think it's, I think these are Sakura blossoms. Is that what they're called? Yeah, they are. I'm pretty sure. Sakura. And I think that's a blossom. I could be wrong. Sakura blossom. Pretty sure. Anyways, so it's regular flavor. It might taste a little bit different because it's the Japanese version, but it's not like a weird flavor. Like it's not a, I don't know if I'm explaining that right. It's Coca-Cola flavor. So fun though. This is my favorite thing about Japanese treat boxes is when you get limited edition items, and I love when we get stuff like Pocky because I'm familiar with it. I also really love Kit Kats. Just want to throw that out there. I think the May box has Kit Kats in it. Anyways, so many treats, so much fun. Tokyo Treat, you have a few to choose from. I recommend the premium box. You can also check out Yumi Twins, which is like a plushie toy subscription, super cute. And then No Make No Life, which is like a makeup subscription. So they've kind of like got it covered. I love it. I'll put the details down below, and thanks for watching.